Geert and his wife look frozen mid-motion.
One of her memories.
It is blurred, incomplete. You must restore it.
Tattered decorations for a special occasion. A wedding veil? Just like the one Olgierd's holding. Perfect match.
Your health, my dear wife.
And yours, my husband.
In my land, custom calls that newlyweds be greeted with bread and salt. But we're alone for now.
I need none but you. Oh, if only this moment could last forever.
I shall see what I can do. But come in and see our home.
Gladly, but I know this sounds silly, yet the house has sat empty for so long and I'm...
Afraid of spiders. I know. I swept them all up and tossed them in the garden.
My knight, you've seen to everything.
Coming. A wraith?
No, a nightmare.
A fear crystallized, one you must now face.
Another dream of the past, but this one's incomplete too.
Silver thread, pearls, it all must have cost a fortune. A lavish feast, trying to impress the guests. Olgierd's wife liked flowers. Judging by the ornamentation, this might be hers. Just a little different than the painting. These were lit in the painting, but that's not all.
My darling, is everything all right? You seem pale, out of sorts.
Everything's fine, really. But why don't you tell me how you fare? I'm ever so happy to see you. Except, why didn't Grandmama and Grandpapa come?
It's a long, rugged journey. Muddy.
They still refuse to meet me. Is that it? And what's this?
We've brought some of Iris's things. Her favorite brush, her cherished doll. This for you.
Banknotes.
We paid off your debts, bought them out, to avoid bringing shame to the family.
So nice of Mama and Papa to remember me.
Olgierd. Now you see his true nature? I warned you before the wedding. A ruffian and a boor who keeps the company of bandits. Are you not afraid to live under one roof with that rabble?
Stained towel. Didn't wash it all off. Got some on the towel. A nightshirt. Never worn, I think. Rick's almost gone.
What time is it?
It's late. Sleep.
Up all night in your study again, I see. What have you got on your hands?
Nothing. Got a bit dirty, that's it.
Is that blood? Have you hurt yourself?
Ink stains. I was writing letters. I shall go to Oxenfurt soon. Perhaps you'd come with me.
Oh, that's a marvelous idea. A trip would do us both so much good.
Then it's decided. Now, time for bed. I'm exhausted.
I shan't fall asleep now. It's out of the question. Come, I shall finish your portrait.
Another blurred memory. Geared, but the details are off. Living tableau's missing something. fresh, as if someone just rinsed it. Living tableau's gotta look just like the painting. Maybe this. Maybe on this side. Let's try this. This goes here. Fits, I think. Finally, just like the picture.
Smile a bit wider.
Like this.
You were meant to smile, not bare your teeth. No, still wrong. Smile like you did when Papa agreed we could marry. Please? You're useless. I can tell something's bothering you.
I've a bit of work I should see to.
Again? Olgierd, we agreed not to keep any secrets from one another. We promised.
Forgive me. I don't wish to discuss this.
Olgierd. Olgierd!
Master von Everick's study. Here he immersed himself in the arcane arts.
Pentagrams here to bind summoned beings. Lines aren't all clear, though. Need chalk to fix them. Then I can set out the candles. Manor was depressingly gloomy in the winter. Blood pacts. War on foreign presences. A tome about parleying with demons. Beeswax candles. Of mystery. Between worlds, the library of an occultist. magic. That should do it. Now for the candles. How about this?
Come back! We must talk!
Go away. I wish to be alone.
Not this time. Come out at once!
Leave me be. I merely want to work in peace. What other spell must I use, damn it? I've tried them all. I wish to end our pact. I summon thee!
Drained to the last drop. A beer tankard, but there was vodka in it, so this is when he started smoking. Probably not right. So that's how he whiled away the long winter evenings. Contract between Iris and Olgierd. Her father must have been holding the contract.
Furthermore, it is agreed that Iris shall be accorded the respect she is owed, that you shall heed her counsel and requests, and...
Get to the point, Father. My patience runs thin.
Gladly. On Iris's request, I declare this marriage null and void.
You vowed to remain with me till death do us part.
And I've held to my vow. The Olgierd I married is no more.
Breaking a word once given does not come that easy. Believe me.
You shall stay here. Forever.
Enough! You will not command us. You will...
Father! Father! No!
Servants, take this carcass and feed it to the beasts.
Then Von Everick ceased to be human.
Though he still loved his wife.
No, he merely remembered that he should love her.
Let's go upstairs.
We spent much time together here, the three of us.
In silence.
We'll take our places, the same as then.
Small bowl.
You do the rest.
Or soup, maybe. Animal hair. Claw scratches. Got something wrong. There we go. Single place setting. No others on the table. Probably not right. A platter. A large clay bowl. This was yours. Perfect match. You actually ate from these bowls?
Of course not. I already told you, we're not animals.
But the caretaker would set them out all the same, as ordered.
Another monstrosity. I begged you to stop this. Those two are too many as it is.
The dog and cat keep you company. This one will protect you. Care for the house, no matter what happens.
Before, I wished to know what was going on in that head of yours. I thought perhaps I could help. Now, I care not the slightest what you think or how you feel.
I feel nothing.
Just as I no longer know if I still hate you. Go, Olgierd. I want you out of my sight.
Olgierd von Everick failed to understand we'd never be able to replace him.
His spectre now casts a shadow over Lady Iris's every remembrance. We're almost at our journey's end.
What's there?
Iris von Everick's greatest fear.
My dearest wife, letters from Olgierd to Iris, were I only as skilled with words as I am with my blade, especially now, when an icy void grips my heart. I see how you look at me, and I see you wither. I cannot help you. But I believe I can cease harming you. This letter and this rose are my farewell. May you live in health and remember but the good times, Olgierd.
Any last words?
That's just to deal with Witcher.
You're not him.
Wait, I want to talk.
Not here. Not in this place. I'm sorry. I mistook you for another.
For Olgierd?
I thought he'd returned. To me.
What are you? A ghost? An illusion?
I am sadness.
Saw you before, but you weren't yourself. And I saw you again in your memories.
We've met. I don't recall. I had bad dreams. That is all I know.
I've come for the violet rose Olgierd gave you.
On the day we saw one another for the last time, I dried it and placed it in our chamber, at my bedside. I lay there for days, staring at it, until at last it crumbled into dust, as did I soon after.
So, the rose is gone?
Not from this world. Look, you buried my body and the flowers bloomed once more. And I was held in a deep, dark sleep. Only now have I awoken, just like my beautiful rose. When you placed the sketchbook on my grave, I remembered learning to draw my husband's face. Tell me, how is Olgierd? Healthy? Does he fare well?
Your husband's got a powerful enemy. Gaunter O'Dim. Know the name?
I cursed the day I first heard it.
Who is he, and how'd he step into your lives?
It's my fault. It was for me Olgierd summoned the Man of Glass. And it was my fault he wished for riches, then immortality for us both. Olgierd will best Odin, won't he? Now tell me, how is my husband?
Your husband hunts out ever stronger sensations. He tempts fate, because at heart he's unhappy.
At heart he is stone, so nothing has changed. And did Olgierd mention me? What did he say?
Not much, but I didn't ask about you. He just sent me to retrieve the rose.
The rose? The last I have left of him. His last gift.
Got a feeling the rose is important to you, more than a memento.
I remember so little. Yet when I think of my rose, I begin to recall what was. The world around me turns real. And my eyes open wide and I recognize things. Remember who I am and who I was.
A friend once told me about a case like this. Could be strong emotions that bind you to the rose, feelings we witchers call pins. They're what keeps you in this world.
Like an insect pinned in a collection case. Horrible.
Need to be honest. If I take the rose, you might cease to exist, as might the world you built around you.
And what will happen then? Shall I be free of the suffering, the sadness? Is it the void that awaits?
I don't know.
I don't wish to suffer any longer. But I fear there will be cold and darkness until there is nothing at all.
I need the rose. Will you give it to me?
It's so fragile. Look, the petal edges have turned crimson, as they were on the day I received it. The one thing missing is the single drop of dew which slid down the leaf when I took the rose in hand. Or was it blood? Because I pricked my finger. I can't remember. You know, I never did read the letter from Olgierd. I didn't have to, and I needn't have kept the flower he left me. I've come to a decision. I shall give you the rose.
Our service thus ends. Thank you, stranger, for freeing us.
Before we go, some advice. Beware of the one called the Man of Glass. Stand in his way, and you'll meet a fate worse than death. Seek salvation in glass that can't be broken.
Glass that can't be broken?
So long.
I'll remember you, Iris von Everek.
That no longer matters. Farewell.